गुड इवनिंग, आई हूं प्रताप सिंह, यू आर वॉचिंग न्यूज एक्स. आवर बिग फोकस दिस आवर इज द डिसाइसिव स्टेप दैट हैज बीन टेकन बाय इंडिया टुडे एज फार एज आवर आउटर स्पेस पॉलिसी एंड प्रोग्रेस इज कंसर्न्ड. इन एन एड्रेस टू द नेशन टुडे, प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी सेड द 27th मार्च मस्ट बी मार्क्ड एज अ प्राउड डे इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया. With this latest space mission, India has now entered the exclusive space club, coming at power with America, Russia, as well as China. In an entirely indigenous effort, India launched Mission Shakti, an anti-satellite mission that targeted a low-orbit live satellite. The mission was a difficult operation, which was successful within 3 minutes of its launch. Well, the Prime Minister said today, Mission Shakti was an important step towards securing India's safety, economic growth, as well as technological advancement.
आज 27 मार्च कुछ ही समय पूर्व भारत ने एक अभूतपूर्व सिद्धि हासिल की है. भारत ने आज अपना नाम अंतरिक्ष महाशक्ति स्पेस पावर के रूप में दर्ज करा दिया है. अब तक दुनिया के 3 देश अमेरिका, रूस और चीन को यह उपलब्धि हासिल थी. अब भारत चौथा देश है जिसने आज यह सिद्धि प्राप्त की है.
All right, and let's open this up. Joining us live this evening is Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, former Director General of DRDO. Professor S.K. Dhaka, space scientist, is joining us live in our studio. Lieutenant D.R. Soni, commanding officer, Indian Army Southern Command, is also live with us in our studio. Colonel Dinesh Nain, satellite and missile system expert, is live with us on the broadcast. Sumit Peer, satellite technology expert, also joins us live. Professor Madhav Narapath, editorial director of the Sunday Guardian, will be joining us shortly. And Air Vice Marshal Sunil Nanutkar, defense analyst, is also live with us on the broadcast. Let me begin with you first, Professor Dhaka.
Yes.
You know, according to you, what really is are the main achievements through this successful testing today? What was the objective, according to you, and what has now been achieved? And what does this convey to, of course, the entire world community?
I think we are the proud nation today. And India now is among the fourth nation in the world to achieve this kind of the technology. So we have got this advancement technology. And we are capable of like hitting the low Earth orbit satellite it's with a very high precision. So that is the most important point I think I would like to mention today. And I would like to congratulate the entire scientific community of the DRDO and ISRO and the people who are involved in this because it takes a long time. So it's not only like one day job. It takes like years, like 2, 3 years, 4 years to work on those technological points. And then finally, this is the day that we have achieved this technological advancement for the
Absolutely.
Country.
Yeah. And let me just quickly correct Lieutenant D.R. Soni's designation. He's, of course, former commanding officer of the Army Southern Command. Yes. But, sir, you know, at the end of the day, as far as security is concerned, what is your analysis of what really has been achieved today in terms of this successful testing of the ASAT?
Okay, Uday, it's a step up. It's a great step up. And frankly, to come onto a table which has the USA, USSR and China, it's a big deal, number one. Number two, now we are going to be stood up and looked in the eye too, because otherwise not many of us were giving us that kind of an izzat in the World Committee of Nations as superpowers, despite being nuclear powers. Number three, satellites have been ruling this Earth and mankind for ages. A lot of action has been planned and demonstrated by various nations to deal with satellites in case of eventuality, definitely in military means. And these were all soft kills, you know, countermeasures, blanking out satellites, flana dimkana. We have demonstrated a kinetic kill. We've blown out a satellite from the sky. This gives you the opportunity and the capability to deal with the communication system, the targeting system, the travel system, the navigation system, a whole lot of civilian as well as military. activities which a satellite today facilitates, especially in the world of network-centric warfare. Satellites have an immense role to play. And if we are a nation who's got the capability to down a satellite by kinetic means, we mean business, and absolutely, the world has to stand up and take notice, sit up and take notice. I must compliment the DRDO and our scientist fraternity. It's not an easy job.
Yeah.
You must remember, the IM, the Integrated Guided Missile Development Program, is one of the feathers in the DRDO cap.
Yep.
And they've done a brilliant job. Yep. This is definitely an added feather. And, you know, an added thing is, when they, and if they, which surely it will happen, have an NTP table, a NPT table, a non-proliferation treaty table for space, India is going to be sitting there.
Yeah.
If we, you know, if we hadn't tested this now and demonstrated this capability, it's a technology demonstrator, we could have kept saying, we've got this, we've got this, we've got this.
Okay.
But now we will have to be taken onto that table, and that brings us at par with the USA, USSR, and China. Big
it
thing.
Enables,
big thing. We should feel so proud.
It enables the global community to look at us with respect.
Yes,
and of course,
for
it's
sure.
a big message,
for
says
sure.
Lieutenant General Soni. Air Vice Marshal Nanotkar, you know, come in here on also this being a deterrent as well. At the end of the day, with this capability now that we've successfully tested out, no one will try and shoot down our satellite, will they? Because we have the prowess to shoot down any other satellite. So it's a big deterrent as well.
Yes, of course. But Uday, before I get to answering your question, first of all, big compliments to our scientific community and the DRDO for achieving what they have done today. This is a logical progression of what the progress in this field has been happening over the years. You know, we first shot down ballistic missiles. We had that program going on, and we demonstrated that capability. And now this is a logical next step. And mind you, in 2008, 2006 is the period where these activities by the three countries that my friend General Soni has just stated, and everybody knows that we have joined that league. And having demonstrated this capability, now it is well known to the entire world that India means business as far as the space is concerned. And mind you, this we have done it logically, systematically, following all bounds of rules and regulation that govern the space activities. We are signatory to all space treaties, and within those bounds we have demonstrated this capability. And that is what the world respects today. And I think it is a huge step in terms of having a homegrown capability to demonstrate that if somebody unnecessarily uses the space for wrong purposes, with wrong intent, we are fully capable of destroying those satellites which they place, whether it is microsatellites, which are, we know that they are there orbiting, and they can be used against our own satellite for, like, for navigation satellites, for our Rikian surveillance ISR satellites, communication satellites. So if somebody means mischief and wrongs us in space, we are today capable of taking them on fully. It's a big achievement. First step, we should be, you know, now confident of growing in that field. And also it will have a huge impact on our position worldwide in UN, in our Security Council, you know, claims. So all in all, it's a big achievement, and come at a right time.
Absolutely. You know, Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, if I can draw you in here, you are, of course, former Director General of the DRDO. You'll be extremely pleased at what's happened today. But Dr. Kumar, obviously, this is a big win for the DRDO and the ISRO and, of course, our country at large. But it's not happened overnight, has it? It's obviously happened after a lot of planning, after a lot of work on this particular technology, which was successfully exhibited today. At the end of the day, I believe the test today was successful within 3 minutes of the commencement of the operation. I'm being told we've lost Dr. Kumar there, but Colonel Nen, you can take that. Colonel Dinesh Nen, you can take that, sir.
Yeah, Udayji, you have to see it in a larger perspective. Initially, if you see that we used to be hiring something called a GPS from America. And then It was in the hands of America whether they can support you in GPS or not, ground positioning system which they were providing you that. So firstly, the India, what we did is that we had our own indigenous GPS system which we first achieved ourselves. Secondly, if you recently remembered that S-400, that anti-ballistic missiles from Russia has been bought by us. So after buying this stuff, we were having the second defense with us. But indigenously, when we went for this particular, anti-satellite missile, which we achieved the target today,
yeah,
is basically targeting those satellites which are in the LEO, that is low Earth orbit. They are basically three portions: low Earth orbit, medium Earth orbit, which you call it MEO, and GEO. Starts from 300 to 1200 kilometers of range from the Earth's surface. So maximum of the satellites of communication basically are into the LEO, that low Earth orbit. And also, let's not forget that all the intercontinental ballistic missiles follow the same route. So what we developed then now was a tracker satellites which can trace, which can hold on to the object which is moving into that space of ours. And after doing that, the message is passed technically, if I tell you in the broad sense for the viewers, it's passed down on the ground radars. These ground radars now calculate that if a satellite or a ballistic missile is traveling in this low Earth orbit, and that is to a speed of approximately 5.7 kilometers per second, then after 3 minutes, where it will going to coincide with this projectile once we fire it, and it goes to that place in 3 minutes.
Right.
So it's an extreme accuracy which we have achieved today. Now implications on our neighbors.
Yeah.
See, Pakistan complete satellite system is dependent on China. And as far as China is concerned, we very well know that China is always with Pakistan. It has been amply proved during this Masood Azhar case and everything happening around. So now, where were we lacking that proficiency which China had against us after 2007? And this was that they had developed this anti-satellite missile in 2007. And 2012, as one of the head of the DRDO, V.K. Srivastava, not Srivastava, I think, that time he was the head of the, 2012 head of the DRDO.
Saraswat.
V.K. Saraswat. Saraswati said ki they had planned everything, blocks were ready. It was to be just messed up, but they were not getting the nod from the government to do so. Well, there may be some implications worldwide at that time, and probably what government did, I can't comment on that. But yes, after taking on this decision, and if today, when Prime Minister had to come in front of the public, it was not for the domestic consumption, please let me tell you that. Because if you remember in 2007, when China had taken on this project and they proved to the world about their having that efficiency in killing a satellite, there was a lot of criticism from the worldwide. So a Prime Minister of the country had to come up, and what he said while addressing the scientists, that we have developed this system for peaceful measure. We are not going to use it for against any other country or in an aggressive manner. So it was having a different implication of Prime Minister coming ahead and addressing the nation, in fact I will say through nation to the world. So what political party is saying, I will not get into that.
You made a valid point, Karan, and I will come back to you. Let me quickly get in the others for their opening comments, and then I will come back to some of the other points you raised. Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, I'm being told, is back with us. Dr. Kumar, of course, Karan Nen there was elaborating on what all has been achieved and what already would have gone into to this successful execution today. And obviously, it's something that didn't happen overnight, is it?
Yeah. No, you are true. This is any project when it's taken, it takes time. And as they have told you, that India is self-sufficient in missile technologies. You know, we have given ample of missiles, Agni 5, BrahMos, Agni 1, Prithvi, etc. We were ready in 2011 also, as you are telling. But then there should be some sort of freedom to be given to the scientists to do that. So when this project Shakti was taken, and you have seen the result, that India, with the same DRDO technologies which we had, we have developed these technologies indigenously. Because as people are saying, because I can assure you, nobody in the world will give us a critical technologies.
Yes.
This has to be a homegrown. And let me compliment all the scientists of DRDO and DRDO chief also, and the government also, who had allowed us to do this sort of thing, and we have done it. The advantage of this unique thing is that we have now capability may exist, but the demonstration of capability is very important.
Okay.
And this is today, the demonstration has been done, and we were able to destroy the satellite, whether it is through this sort of thing. Moreover, China has already done it in 2007, America, US also did it in 1959, and Russia did it in 1960 and 71. Then when China did it, and we know we have a lot of issues with China, why we were silent is difficult for me to answer. But I must tell you that whether it is seeker, whether it is a radar, whether the data and all sort of thing, everything has been done indigenously, and we have proved to the world that India once decide can do it, and we have done it today, and that is how the things are.
No, that's a valid point you're making. Let me quickly bring in Professor Madhav Nalapat before I also get in Sumit Peer. Professor Nalapat, sir, your initial readings of the takeaways from today's test and the message being sent out through all of this to, of course, the global community at large, but also particularly to adversaries of India.
I'd like to say that if we had done it in 2011 and we had done more tests, there's no doubt that we could have had a very perfect system by now. But of course, the fact is that on the first time itself, we succeeded, which is the only country, neither Russia, nor the US, nor China succeeded in the first attempt. We did. But I would only like to point out that our political leaders didn't seem to have very high opinion of India. They seem to believe India should always be a second-class power. Otherwise, what is the reason for them to deny our scientists the opportunity to test this back in 2011 or 2012? So we have waited 7 years for this, frankly, and I think that is something which is a commentary on the political leadership during that period, a leadership which included the BJP and the Congress Party, both. Having said that, I want to point out the regional context. You have a situation where you've got a nuclear-armed Pakistan, which has daily been making nuclear threats against us. This kind of a capacity makes it very, very possible to take out the guidance systems and to take out a lot of the lethality in the kind of weaponry that Pakistan has got. And I think from that point of view, it's a clear demonstration to Pakistan that, look, don't try and threaten us. We are not going to be afraid of your threats, and we can deal with every one of your threats. I'm delighted that this has taken place. Of course, it has taken place in the final 2 months of the term of the Modi government. It could have taken place in 2015 or 2016. It did not. It happened now. But better late than never.
Okay, Sumit, your reading of it today.
I think, Uday, if you talk of it from a technological perspective, it's a fantastic thing to achieve, because the people who understand and appreciate satellite technology will save you. It's nothing less than a marvel what we have achieved. 2-3 points. First of all, it's indigenous in development. What rightly said, you cannot get this technology. I think Colonel Nayan rightly put it, what is the need of having this technology with India? Because we have a strategic deterrence against China. You know, if our all, submarine comms, our ICBMs, any kind of comms today runs on satellite. Now, if China had this capability to bring down our satellites, military and comms satellites, you could have a submarine fleet wandering nowhere in the sea. We could have our ICBMs not working and things like that. My question is, when we knew that China had this capability, we had to, in fact, long back go and develop this. Now, we didn't only develop it, we accepted to the world that what we have. So what we have done, we have strengthened our Army, Navy and Air Force, and we have strengthened the country's defense many folds. And technically speaking, there are technologically advanced countries like in SATCOMs, if you talk about there, France, there's Israel. Even they do not have this technology. This is not a technology, Uday, which is easy to have and get. The accuracy levels have to be accurate to the last micron.
Right.
And so technology is a marvel, but again, giving it to the military and the defense, we have doubled or tripled their strength because we have a strategic deterrence, which we were lacking. And the last point is that we have told to the world that when it comes to technology, it was cryogenic intelligence, it was ICBMs, it was Akash, Nag, Prithvi, and now this, Shakti. We have demonstrated to the world that we can develop and deliver when we need the thing. Of the only thing what was lacking was the political will.
Okay.
We cannot take away the credit from the government, because DRDO and the scientists always had the capability. ISRO is a fantastic organization. DRDO is an excellent organization. What Sir rightly said, what was lacking was the political will. It's like you give them incubation, you give them the necessary steps. Our army has always delivered. Our scientists have always delivered. What the country lacked was the political will. So it's a three-way victory. We have the political will. We have the scientists who can deliver. We have the army which is strengthened.
Lieutenant General Soni, I want you to quickly react to what China has said today. China has said, we're aware of relevant reports and we hope that all countries will earnestly safeguard lasting peace and tranquility in outer space. And Pakistan has come out and said that Pakistan is a strong proponent of prevention of arms race in outer space, and boasting of such capabilities is reminiscent of Don Quixote's tilting against windmills court.
Uday, in today's world, I'll just equate this a little bit with the sport of cricket. So sportsmanship was replaced by gamesmanship. Imran Khan, remember?
Yeah.
And gamesmanship has now been replaced by an utterly offensive kind of sport. You please look at a bowler when he gets a batsman out, he's abusing the hell out of that batsman. What I'm trying to say. In today's world, offensive spirit is what makes people sit up and take notice of you. It is not how good you are, what is your capability. If you are meek, if you are subdued, people will always ride over you. It's when you stand up and dig in your heels and show your strength is when people sit up and take notice. Now China and Pakistan taken unawares, this is not completely the best situation for both of them. Why? China has the satellites, Pakistan uses them. The ultimate intent of all these countries, both these countries, is against India, if to be used militarily, you understand? And I'm saying not only for weaponizing, even to switch off our computer systems, our internet, our water systems, our airline navigation systems, our railway navigation and movement systems. You know, look at the chaos that would happen in a country if that's such a kind of a thing. And China is known to do this. They have got active units which are doing this. It's all through network-centric warfare. It's all through satellite. Suddenly, they've been shaken up because we have stood up, not acquired the capability, we've stood up and shouted out in front of a world saying that we have this, better watch out. And that is something which I'd like to see how these countries react. Frankly, Pakistan is now left floundering because I mean, he doesn't have the technology, he's looking for doles in any case, he's a weak nation economically, scientifically very little, so he has to look to Big Brother China. And China, of course, suddenly being shattered because he always thought this was one weapon he had, which we didn't have. Now suddenly we also have the capability. I must put in a bit of caution here, Uday. It's not the end result. This is a technology demonstrator. To get into this, to actually weaponize such a thing, a kinetic kill vehicle, a large amount of development is still to take place. Probably will take years still. But we've shown to the world that indigenously, without help from anyone, we've developed this, so watch out. Look where all we can
That's
go.
That's an important point.
And that's something which and everyone perhaps needs to sit up and take notice
of. Professor Dhaka. You want to weigh in on that. On the way ahead now, at the end of the day, this is one step achieved, says Lieutenant Soni. And obviously there's more to be done in the years ahead, but it's sent out the message that we wanted to send out. We are bolstering our you know, our outer space program. There have been very successful you know, missions which have been launched in the recent past. But this is, of course, a way of protecting us.
Exactly.
It's a deterrent.
In fact, we are in a very strong position now. And it was needed. It was needed because China was having this technology, as you mentioned, and we were really looking for this badly. And probably our scientific community has shown it, that that is strength, that they can make it. And of course, because the BMD interceptor was needed, and now anybody can think, any nation can think twice before they launch the things over Indian space. So we are having the space strength now with us. That is the most important point I'd like to mention. And of course, about the precession, as you mentioned, that we have a perfect precession, because when the satellite comes up, and when you launch the missile system, it moves slowly by that time. So you have to calculate that how much it has moved.
The last micron.
So because that precision is very, very important.
What is very worrisome for China also, Then now suddenly, we are sitting on a table which is equivalent to them.
Yeah.
So it was always them having larger numbers, better technology, making better fighters, more submarines, better submarines, larger warships. And suddenly, India is now sitting on a table where you have USA, USSR and China, and India is also there. So buddy, you better watch out.
Absolutely.
And hence, you cannot take a decision which is entirely in Chinese national interest. Suddenly, regional power plays will have to be resorted to, and regional balance will need to be taken into consideration.
India has a strong say.
There is one more thing that I want to bring out. There is a hypothetical war game which US talks about, is the Star Wars. The concept is you put up a satellite in the sky and load a missile into it. It can be a nuclear or a non-nuclear missile, and you can hold any country to the ransom. So if you have a situation like this now, hypothetical, it's not true, I don't know, maybe US is working on it. If you have a situation like this, which they have claimed they are working on it, now we have an answer to that also. Because somewhere it will be a LEO, MEO or a GEO satellite. With our technology advance, you can even take that up.
You know, it's very important.
It's a big word thing.
Very important to disclose this. You may have it. Like someone, but, I met someone who was saying, you think the UK doesn't have it or France doesn't have it. I'm not bothered whether they have it or not. Maybe they are under the NATO blanket, you see. The fact is, when you disclose it, these people cannot take you lightly anymore. They can't push you around.
And it's announced by nobody less than the Prime Minister.
And you know, someone very rightly said that this talk about the nuclear bogey. So what happened? What is going to happen now is an entirely different kettle of fish. Because suddenly you've got a nuclear bogey, so we've got an equivalence of nuclear arsenal. Now we've got something that will even shoot down your basic living requirements. And that is cataclysmic for any nation. Because today, nations are entirely dependent on satellites and electronics. And God help us, if something goes wrong, your nation goes into turmoil. That is the best form of warfare. You don't have to fire a weapon. You don't have to shoot a bullet at someone to kill him.
That is, and that perhaps because of India joining this very elite club of just four nations, Professor Nalapath, is what's perhaps sent China and Pakistan into a tizzy today.
Absolutely. Look, you know, Uday, the fact is that all this talk about China, frankly, makes me feel a little uneasy.
Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, I'm just coming to you, sir. I'm just coming to you after Professor Nalapath. Yes, Professor Nalapath, go ahead.
It's one of the first principles of warfare that we don't talk about a two-front war. And quite frankly, whether it is in 1965, whether it is in 1971, whether it is in Kargil in 1999, when Pakistan attacked us, the Chinese did not intervene. And I really do not believe they have any reason to intervene, nor do we have any reason to fight them. So I'm not one of those who keep talking about the so-called, you know, China-India war coming in. I don't believe that situation. So far as Pakistan is concerned, it's a different situation. And I think we need to ensure that just like the Americans realized that Pakistan was a poison pill which was poisoning them, the Chinese also need to be made to realize that Pakistan is a poison pill that will poison them. If Pakistan is denuded of support from China, Pakistan is helpless. I'm very sure that hundreds of calls are being made to Beijing now. Please give us something like this. Please give us something like this. All made in China. So we can also shoot it. And we can also pretend that we're equal to India.
They can send them the new Chinese.
No, that's a very point. Dr. Sudarshan Kumar. Yes, sir.
I just want to tell you one thing. One unique thing in this case is that the enemy satellite can be either blinded or the disrupted communication system can be disrupted. And this is another milestone in the history of India today, that we are able to demonstrate to the world that we have developed this completely indigenous technology. More so, these days, these technology, we will have to go a step further to carry out more work on this sort of thing, but we have entered into a new area. We were working earlier, the war through air, ground, either sea, and now we have entered into a space. Now this is definitely a deterrence to the world that India has a capability, and once he has a capability through his own indigenous technologies, DRDO has done that, and then they could say that this is possible. And not only that, keeping in view that many more things can be done in this direction also.
Absolutely.
You know, Uday, I was speaking with some foreign officers.
Yes.
At a recent get-together, You know, there's a perception in the West where they have started equating, or they have for a long time equated Pakistan with India.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
Why? Because for some reason, maybe we haven't projected ourselves mm-hmm. so well, maybe yeah. they have more, yeah. you know, and things like that. Now, with this kind of a development and this kind of a technology demonstrator, mm-hmm. suddenly Pakistan has been left much below.
Yeah, correct.
You get it? Suddenly, India yeah. has gone into the yeah. Super League. Yeah. Again, yeah. I'm saying, let's not count our chickens because yeah. a lot of work still has to
yeah.
be done.
Yeah.
But I'm saying again, I'm repeating myself, this is a technology demonstrator. Pakistan is nowhere. Mm-hmm. His satellites are all Chinese.
Yeah.
So he's got nothing to look forward to in the form of space. Mm-hmm. So he's got nothing to look forward to in the form of space. Mm-hmm. Except from the Chinese.
Yeah.
Now suddenly there is a difference for the world, because even the nukes, we had nukes, they got nukes or whatever it is.
Yeah.
But this is a technology demonstration which has now changed the playing field.
Completely.
It was so-called level in the Brits or in the, so I'm so sorry, in the Western world,
yeah.
not the Brits, the Western world. And now it is no more a level playing field. Now people will have to sit up and take notice that, yes, India is definitely different.
You know, Air Vice Marshal Nanotkar, and where we saw, of course, how our space program aids our military, you know, one concrete, clear example was, of course, the Pokhran tests, you know, which were successfully executed, you know, aided and abetted by our satellites. And at the end of the day, this advancement of our space program will also boost our Air Force, Navy and Army capabilities, won't it, as well?
Yeah, of course, like we have been talking about network-centric warfare, and every capability that was demonstrated till date requires support from satellites in various forms. Mm-hmm. Like we said, it's in terms of communication requirement of the all the three services, right from underwater till the highest flying aeroplane that we use today, navigation capability, and what GPS gives us certain capability, and we know the accuracy that we can achieve in an open domain GPS from there to our Gagan satellite constellation that has been put in space, which will give us area-specific accuracy of the highest nature that the defense services require. So when we use these applications, and today's capability demonstrate that these applications will be continuously made available to the defense services if should there be a requirement to go in for war and use these applications. So therefore, nobody can today, interfere with our capability that exist because of launch of these satellites by the ISRO and the DRDO into the space. And it is not only this hard kill option that has been demonstrated today is a significant step, because while we are signatory to all the treaties, like I said earlier, like there is a treaty where near proxy warnings are given to each other when the satellites drift or they go closer to each other, causing danger to the other satellites. There is a warning given,
yeah.
and necessary steps taken. So it is like a classical demonstration of warfare, that is defensive and offensive capability that you have developed in a normal conventional warfare. Now you have extended it to the outer space, and this is General Soni has been saying, this is a technology demonstrator. We have to take many steps ahead to build full-fledged capability to defend our satellites the way we have been defending our skies all this while. So I think it is a baby step in a right direction. It has come at a right time, and now is the time to consolidate hereafter, so that our
That's an interesting
space
analogy that you've got. Air Vice Marshal Nanotkar there says, General Soni,
that
it's like
of the class of
quickly complete that point before I take your analogy forward. Yes, Air Vice Marshal Nanotkar.
Yeah. So Yeah, so this is a step which will not only strengthen all the three defense services, but even civilian application, because tomorrow there are some essential civilian application that can be disrupted. One of the panelists just brought out what all applications are, critical. And those applications also can be disrupted. And now you have joined the gang of people like nations like USA and Russia. And mind you, you covered the comments by Chinese and Pakistanis. There are no adverse comments, or there are no, comments coming in from USA or USSR against what we have tried out. So it's a very logical progression, and India has gone about it very systematically and within the bounds of rules, as I said earlier.
Absolutely. Before I get in, Colonel Dinesh, that analogy, Air Vice Marshal Narutkar was referring to, like we have our missile systems on ground to protect and defend our skies from any adversary, an aircraft or something that's coming in. It's a similar technology to protect our satellites as well.
Yeah, Uday, space is the final frontier.
Yeah.
And ultimately, when it gets too crowded with weapon systems, technologies on Earth, whether on the ground, whether at sea, whether in the air, we have to look elsewhere. And it is space which gives us the opportunity. Trust me, there will be a non-proliferation treaty in place very soon. And hence, that's why I keep saying, I'm so glad this happened. It was useless, it was worthless if we had it and did not disclose it. This shows that we've got the will to do it. And this shows that we've arrived, and we will be deciding the NPT on this space, arms and weapons, and weaponizing or arming space. I just have something that I'd like to say. Firstly, we must see this through. It should not remain a technology demonstrator. Yeah. It must be pushed to its logical and successful completion as a system. That's number one. Number two, this is never going to be the first line of defense. Yes, it will be a line of defense, but we must continue developing and modernizing our three services, because ultimately, yes, this will blank out your systems. Yes, this will create chaos and mayhem in your country with your water, electricity, communications, navigation, but ultimately, the defense services will have to fight a war. And for that, we must continually upgrade our defense forces in whichever way possible. Yeah. Now, this is something which we'll have to make a probability and a prioritized development schedule, which is definitely on the cards.
You know, and at the end of the day, Colonel Nain, the fact is that while Pakistan was never really in this space race, they have a very weak space program, and they're, bankrupt as a nation. They cannot afford to either. Build this kind of technology, they always rely on China. But where it's pretty significant is that we've managed to successfully test such a technology today, way before, the biggest economies of the world, be it the UK, the France, and other, superpower and P5 countries.
Yep.
See, Uday, let me start by saying this, that the zero was invented in this country by our scientists. And had that zero not been there, probably no science would have been there. Now, coming down to, I got a few observations on what happened in Operation Shakti today, and I would like to put it across this way. Taking across what AVM said just now, that whether civil or military interruptions by these ASAT missiles or use of this kind of a technology, I personally feel it is not only at the geo level. What we have achieved today, I think we can hit anything, whether it is in LEO or MEO or GEO, any of the orbits, we can hit, because you very well know that we are planning Mars, planning now about going to the Mars. That level of scientific development has taken place by DRDO, and there's no words I can praise them. Now, coming down to Pakistan, a country which does not have even $20 million to survive, and asking, Saudi Arabia and King Hussein, just that too, he has given them just to take that, oil refinery at the port, which China was thinking that they will have it. But what is Pakistan without China? Pakistan is nothing. Whether you take it their aircrafts, whether you take it their satellites, or any of the things. So I differ with one of the panelists saying that we should not think about China. See, China, after block and road this thing and CPEC plan, has tried to surround India from Sri Lanka, from Bangladesh, and from other countries, Malaysia and everywhere. So it has got its own plan. But today's development which has taken place, it has definitely shattered China in a very big way. Because now the technology which we have today, it is going to just shatter all the plans which China was having in its mind. Coming down to third front, which if I may say so, regarding at the world level. You see, India's gates are open for United Nations Security Council, I think so. And in NPT, it's going to be a member. So, overall position of India is going to be much different after getting this technology, and definitely in coming days ahead, we are going to watch it.
Okay.
What are going to say?
No, that's a valid point that you're raising. Dr. Sudarshan Kumar. Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, at the end of the day, what next now? This has been done today. Lieutenant Soni is saying it shouldn't be just a test, but it should be developed now into a more mainstream technology and taken forward into perhaps more such advancements as well, more such deterrence as well, more such anti-satellite systems as well, at the end of the day, that we can have in place, because space is the next frontier, isn't it?
The one thing I want to tell you, we tested Agni 5, but that was not the end of Agni 5.
Yeah.
We conducted successive trials. We went into canisterized form, and like that, any missile, we have tested BrahMos missile, so many missiles which we have given. So process starts. When the process starts, we start doing the tests, we do the trial, we do the user trial. So there also, the one thing is clear, that ultimately, this is a one step, and there I hope DRDO has a program for that, which I think they will continue to do this work. And further, it will not be left to just a showman show, we have done this trial and then the end of it. It will not happen like that. As the process goes, as you know, we have missile defense systems, and where we could do that, and we have the other so many systems which we have got, and that is not the end. We just show something and then we keep quiet on that, and then I am sure that the DRDO scientists may be looking into that, what next is to be done and how it is to be done. One thing you rest assured, that DRDO has fully developed this technologies, missile technology, and we are self-sufficient in that. We are not dependent on anybody on these issues. More so, similarly, our space program, when you look into it, it is very cost-effective, and we have a mission going to the man in space also, the program which is going on. So as a result, and the budget is not much. So looking into this, our strong points, both at space, in space as well as ISRO's program, or the DRDO program which we are doing that, I am showing that, I am sure that DRDO scientists will definitely work it further in that direction, so that the things will move further ahead, and they might have some plans in that, in this direction. Because technology demonstration is one thing. As one of the panelists was saying, the induction. Induction, of course, takes time. So one has to develop a roadmap for induction. Yeah. Looking into that, I am sure that they will definitely look into that and then prepare some sort of thing, how to go ahead further. And
okay.
That, of course,
yes, go ahead, sir. Lieutenant Soni reacting to
this. Exactly. What I was saying was,
in 2011. That
this is a technology demonstrator. We know we can do this. Now to put it into use as a defense program to take out satellites. And here I'd like to just tell the... That other panelist member who said, why China? Because Pakistan is using Chinese satellites. If they are going to try and put down our systems, and we want to survive those and still fight a war or still survive, we want to take it out. Now we've got the capability. So hence, if we have to achieve that capability, it's not with one system. It has to be a networked system. There have to be multiple launchers in secure places, the electronics of it, the communications of it, the guidance of it. It's going to be a very highly developed system.
Yeah.
Naturally, we are only the fourth country in the world to do it.
Yeah,
and that's why I'm saying that we must now push it with gusto, so that we don't let this be a one-off or a two-off or a three-off. This now has to signal the arrival of India on the world stage as a major player. That is what I meant. And I also would like to reinforce that alongside this, let's continue with the upgrading and the development of the rest of our defense forces. And China, for sure, will assist Pakistan. We should be ready mentally and morally to take out, and yes, wait for the consequences, we'll deal with them, whichever way it may be. Because anything now that harms us must be dealt with. That's the signal that now India is trying to send to the world, and I think it's about time.
Before I get back, Professor Nalapath, yes, Air Vice Marshal Nanutkar also wanted to come.
Yeah, Uday, one little offbeat I would like to go in terms of progression that logically has been happening over the period. Now, just see the successive governments, decision to put at the head of this organization, like the way ISRO has grown and demonstrated our country's capability in space by putting so many satellites today. Now, just see from Dr. Abdul Kalam onwards, Dr. Saraswat, Dr. Subhash Chandra, and now Dr. Satish Reddy. These are all people who have grown in the missile cluster, missile domain, and I think this was the most logical decisions that were happening at government level, successive government level, who have given so much of importance to these program over the years, and I'm sure that the way we are progressing ahead, I'm sure post this technology demonstration, we will have adequate capability build up in a shortest possible time because of this continuity of people working there in the DRDO headquarters. And I think that is one of the best things that that has happened to our country.
Correct.
Yeah.
So, Uday, adding on to what our respective panelists have said, first of all, let's talk from a technology perspective. If you look at a technology perspective, if you bring up down a LEO satellite, technically, you have the capability to bring down a GEO or a MEO, there's no doubt around it. And let me clarify here, if you talk from a technical perspective, it is the major step.
Yeah.
It won't be a small step.
Everyone's been talking about the military aspects as well. Perhaps you can also tell us about the civilian aspects.
Sure.
In terms of surveillance, GPS systems, internet, and other things as well.
You see, now today, a lot of
comms... That have now got protected.
A lot of comms runs on satellites. So first of all, it's not a baby step. It's a full-fledged step to demonstrate this technology. If France does not have it, if Israel does not have it, I beg to differ, it's not a baby step. It is the step. General Saab rightly said, the step, the challenge is to induct it into the forces and how fast can you do it.
Yeah.
Second point I want to make it, we already have the nuclear triad, right? With this step, we have added the fourth dimension of the security, which only four countries in the world have. That's the point number two. And talking of the civil comms, what General Sam rightly said, you have aviation, you have trains, there's a lot of parts of the country.
Banking.
If you look at Leh, Ladakh,
there
are a lot of country parts in the India which are still running on comms. Yeah. If you look at any of the bank ATMs, it still has a VSAT. It's a small antenna which you see. All our ATMs still run on VSAT.
Yeah.
All the military comms runs on VSAT. All the control command system of Army runs on encrypted channels, Navy, submarines. There's no way you can talk to submarines except satcoms.
Yeah. Yeah.
How can you talk to Sukhoi 31 up 30, I don't know how many thousand feet in the air?
Yeah.
So, besides military, we run our trains, we run our satellite, we run our telephones, we run our even basic banking. Mm-hmm. A lot of our ATMs still run on VSATs.
Yes.
So, it has far-reaching implications. It is the fourth dimension of the security which we have added. And what rightly they said, every technology has to evolve. So the natural progression of a technology is Uday to evolve. If you look at a dial phone to a smartphone today, it's evolving.
Yep.
Now after 2 years, we might have facial recognition. 2 years down the line, we might have something which we never imagined.
Mm-hmm.
So let me assure that everybody, if we have this technology, it's only going to go up.
Okay.
It's only going to evolve. So it's there is no way it's going to come back.
One point, quickly, before I get in, Professor Nalapathy.
Because in the next 2 years, within 2 years, probably the India is going to send 3 astronauts in the space.
Right.
So we are consistently working on it. It's over the last 10 years, we had Chandrayaan, we had Mars mission, we have this astronaut soon is coming up.
Governor.
So I think technologically we have really advancement already.
And as this technology is going to go up, there's no way it's going to go down.
Before I get in the global community aspect with Professor Dhaka, Professor Nalapath, while you were saying, of course, that this shouldn't just be read within the prism of our relations with China and a deterrent just against China and, at the end of the day, putting us on par with China. You were wary with that sort of example, which some of the other panelists have also responded to. But what is the message that you believe this has been sent out through today's successful test to the entire global community there? Not just our regional players in Asia, but to the entire world at large.
Uday, please remember what the Prime Minister said today. And what the Prime Minister has done through his very skillful diplomacy over the past few years. He made it very clear this is not directed against any country. And when he said any country, he basically meant one particular country. because the Prime Minister is well aware that Pakistan is in a different league and that there is a very high possibility, frankly, that that country will be irresponsible and behave in such an irresponsible way that war with India becomes inevitable. In that situation, I think the Prime Minister very wisely would like, I'm sure, like all of us would, and I'm sure our service members here who are talking in this particular program also would, ensure that it's a one-front war, so we can concentrate on that particular front. Prime Minister went to Wuhan, had a very good meeting with Xi Jinping, and since then the borders have been quiet. So I want to make the point that we have to focus very frankly in terms of a very important problem we have. Now, again, I go back. It is utterly irresponsible that our politicians in the past did not really test any of this. It's utterly irresponsible, frankly, that they waited so long. Look at the way Pakistan has behaved. Terror attack after terror attack. Provocation after provocation. Now, you know, I'm sure the general knows very well, whenever Pakistani troops face an officer on the other side who is not very assertive, they become very assertive. Right. On the other hand, if the Indian officer is assertive, then they become defensive. Unfortunately, in certain periods of time, the government of the day penalized assertive officers and told them, what are you doing? And, you know, so and very wrong signals were sent. So my point is, because we have delayed this event for too long, we have suffered a lot in terms of attacks by Pakistan and all kinds of other activities by Pakistan.
Yeah.
I fully agree with everybody else. We need to demonstrate our strength. We can't just keep it hidden in a box somewhere. It's got to be demonstrated as a deterrent. And the point I want to make is, this is not an offensive system. I'm talking of defense against an aggressive neighbor. And this is very much a defensive system. If somebody, for example, wants to create mayhem in some of our services using the, you know, satellites, well, we have
General Soni, of course, used General Soni, of course, used a cricketing analogy in the start. I'll use a football analogy. We're not playing offensive, we are playing defensive today. But, you know, Professor Dhaka, at the end of the day, the global community has not reacted negatively at all.
Yeah.
You know, I read out those reactions, of course, of Pakistan and China, which AVM Nanutkar was referring to. But, you know, at the end of the day, there have been no adverse reactions from anyone across the globe. Also, that has a lot to do with, I think, the altitude with which we targeted this satellite. Because it was at a low altitude, so the chances of debris would be
debris
less.
Is okay. We are very safe because the things will come down soon within the next 2-3 days, and probably the DRDO people, they are working on it. Yeah. And
the last time China did a similar test, it affected some Russian satellites.
Yes, correct. It's a danger because all the nearby satellites which are very close to that, so they can be hit by and their communication can be shattered.
Yeah.
So from that point of view, I think very, very, very safe. And it's a wonderful experiment.
You know, Uday, you must also give credit to our diplomatic corps.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Over the last, say, for 3 months, say, February, March, at least 2 months, our diplomatic corps has gone into an overdrive to go and attack world opinion.
Yeah.
And to actually bring world opinion
towards India.
And like I mentioned, not to put Pakistan and India on the same playing level.
Say,
you did this, so he can do this. He did that, so you can do this.
And we saw it now, after the Balakot.
Yes, you saw what happened. Yes. Because so now, why? So if you think that, or if you are bringing out that, yes, a large number of countries, there are only two who've actually reacted negatively, which was bound to happen because it affects them.
Yeah. Yeah.
But for the others, it only shows a country maturing in the scientific field, developing its own capabilities in the scientific field.
Yes.
And for God's sake, we're not going to attack anyone. Yeah. Everyone knows that. India has never attacked anyone.
So already,
but we are going to, if someone at any point of time wants to attack us, attack our civilians and our lives, we have the capability now to protect ourselves. And if this is by kinetic means, so be it.
If you look at it, if you look at the countries broadly, they're classified into three.
Yeah.
Hostile, neutral and friendly.
Okay.
So host friendly countries will welcome it. They have no earth to grind. If you talk about neutral countries, they are not bothered.
Okay.
So if you look at hostile countries, there are only two we have, unfortunately, one on the right and one on the left.
Yeah.
So it was bound as these two hostile countries will come and react, say something.
Yeah. Yes.
But the biggest thing is what I want to bring up is every country has a right to self-defense.
Absolutely.
Has a right to protect its citizens. If India is doing it in the self-defense, because we know a hostile neighbor has this
then
technology
there's nothing wrong with it.
Which can affect us adversely. Okay. What is wrong with that?
Can I just moderate my seemingly offensive tone? I don't believe that we are at war with China or we will ever be.
Yeah.
Because we are two growing economies and no amount of war is good for anyone.
That's what Professor
no
Narayan
one wins.
Said. Yeah. Yeah.
No
yeah.
one wins. It's economically a disaster. We'll both go back 25 years.
Yeah.
It's not that we are against China. What I was trying to put across is that we have got the technology that if any of their technology is being used by, say, Pakistan or anyone else,
we can then defend ourselves. We can counter
that's
it. That's
but
what I said earlier.
What I want to say now is that I also see that having displayed this kind of a capability, I see a growing, there possibly will be a growing bonhomie between China and India, which our diplomatic corps should now make use of and enhance.
That's something we will only see, of course, in the days ahead.
Yeah.
For now, though, it's certainly been a proud day for India. And we salute, you know, the people responsible for this in ISRO, in DRDO, and of course, in the establishment of the state as well. We'll have to leave it at that. My thanks to our panelists for joining us. A quick break on that note. We'll continue our discussion, of course, on this. Appreciate all our panelists joining us for the time being. And thanks to our viewers as well for watching.
Thank you.